Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to my build video. This build uses Leda's sword, a light greatsword that is one of the new weapon types in the DLC. I will also going to be using Harp Bow, just for range damage. All right, let's see. I have my vigor at 60. A higher vigor level means a larger health pool, which allows players to take more damage before dying. Vigor also increases immunity, which provides better protection against ailments like poison and scarlet rot. Additionally, higher vigor levels make armor more effective, giving players more options for what to wear. Mind is there because you will buff with Golden Vow periodically, even on the landscape, and Needle Piercer is quite expensive at 19 FP per use. As always, to me, this stat is also important, along with Vigor. Stamina is so important. It is so important, you can beat the game by only leveling Endurance. I like to light roll. I know for some people, 60 Endurance is pointless. We rather have some points to go to Faith, increasing Faith damage. It just depends on you playstyle. The more Endurance a character has, the larger their stamina bar, and the more actions they can perform before requiring a recharge. Right here, having 11 strength is required to wield the sword. I just went for 29, it's because I feel I do more damage with this number. Leda's sword scales very well with high dexterity. 60 dexterity is best with this weapon, and it does increase the weapon skills. So you're going to want to focus on dexterity probably until you're around 80. Final attribute we're going to talk about is Faith. You can split some of the points from Endurance and put the rest of it in Faith. That will give you more holy damage. 19 Faith is needed to use Leda's sword anyway, so taking it up to 30 makes sense for the build and buffs that I just mentioned. For my primary weapon, I will be using Leda's sword is a light greatsword in Elden Ring. It is a brand new light greatsword in the Shadow of the Erdtree DLC. The latest sword scales primarily with strength, dexterity, and faith, and is a good alternative for faith builds. This weapon also has a starting damage of 101. Weapon skill. Needle Piercer is the unique skill of Needle Knight Leda's weapon, which generates 10 gold needles that pierce their targets all at the same time. The Harp Bow, if nothing else, is a unique weapon. As it is made from a harp, it does play musical notes whenever arrows are fired from it. Despite its unique design, the Harp Bow is a fairly weak weapon to be found so far in the game. It can be upgraded but requires somber smithing stones, which are much harder to find and more limited in a single playthrough. For arrow, you can use holy arrows or whatever arrows you basically have. For armor, since you're playing as Leda, you will need to have her full set, for cosplay purposes only. The talisman I will be using are the two Turtlehead Talisman. This increases your stamina recovery even more than the green Turtle Talisman does. Dragon Crest, Great Shield Talisman enormously reduces physical damage taken by 20%. Players can use talismans in Elden Ring to boost a variety of stats. The Erdtree's Favor Talisman plus 2 increases HP by 4%, stamina by 9.5%, and equip load by 8%. Shard of Alexander greatly boosts the attack power of skills by 15%. Players can use talismans in Elden Ring to boost a variety of stats. For my consumable buffs, Crab boosts physical damage negation by 20% for a time. Golden Vow, consumable, can be used to increase attack by 12.5% and all defenses by 8.8% for 45 seconds. Uplifting Aromatic is a consumable item that boosts ally attack power and reduces incoming damage once. From use, the effect last 40 seconds. This guy just gave up. Don't give up, just keep on fighting. You'll never know, you may get another chance, but whatever. My final thoughts about the build. Despite being holy damage, Leda's sword hits like a truck, and it's pretty awesome. I've seen a few people say that the weapon art is only useful in PvP, or just the weapon entirely. This is not the case at all, and despite the law of regression, benefit rarely having any effect, the needles still do a ton of damage, and you can make them do quite a bit more by pairing it with an extremely underrated but janky side weapon, which we'll have to talk about later. About the bow, Harp Bow is just there to put my opponent to sleep to get free damage. All right, I think that's about it. Like and subscribe for more Elden Ring build guide video.